Hey guys, 2J's here.
What up?
It's 2J's.
Just wanted to do a quick teaching on Luke 14:26. Because it is a scripture that seems to confuse a lot of people. So, Luke 14:26, I think I said it was. So it says, "If anyone comes to me and does not hate his own father, mother, wife, children, brothers, sisters, yes, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Or, if any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple." So that can be a confusing scripture to people, because it totally contradicts the second commandment, the second greatest commandment, that's equal to the first that they were talking about, that Jesus was talking about love God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength, and love all others as yourself. So that's why it may be confusing to people to hear that. But what it's talking about is when you're first coming to God and Jesus. So when I came to God and Jesus, it was that I was, you, like, you get down. Oh, my computer's acting up. Sorry. So you get basically, I was down. I felt broken. I felt betrayed by everyone. And like it says in that one, I think it's in one of the Psalms, where it talks about when I was down and I felt surrounded and I felt like I was dead, basically. Like it felt like I turned to God, I called out and cried out to God, and He answered me and He helped me. So, and that's why, and that says, "I will praise Him and always call upon His name for the rest of my life, as long as I live," and things like that, because... So that's what it's talking about with this scripture. So, like, it's just initially for you to come to know God and Jesus, you have to feel completely down, broken with the world, fed up, like how I clearly felt in my song called Sick of People. When you just get, you have to be completely sick of people, even your own self. You have to be just, you basically get to the point where you hate the world. And then, like in the Psalms, how it says, that one psalm I was talking about, I think it's Psalm 114 or something, it says, you got to that point where you cried out to God and you say, because you were alarmed and down, everyone is a liar. So basically that's what you have to come to the point where you just hate everyone. You're just so tired of the world, even your own self. You have to basically completely become fed up, broken with the world, and just like hate everyone and everything, to the point where you're like, I don't want this anymore. I'm done with this world. Please, God. And you have to cry out to God. That's what that scripture is talking about. So until you get to that point where you literally hate the world, you're so sick of it, everyone, nothing, like they all feel like they're a bunch of liars, like nothing makes any sense, it's all evil, you feel betrayed by the whole world, you just get completely fed up with everyone and everything, even your own self and your own behavior, and how, you know, when you grow up and you're just like, you know, you're just innocently living but then you inherit sin, because we've inherited sin. So it's like, that part doesn't make sense to me, didn't make sense to me too. It's like, how are you going to hold me accountable for sins that I inherited? Like, I wasn't Adam in the garden, didn't have that chance to say no to that apple or, the, you know, to the fruit. So it's like, so you inherited that. So it's like, I need saving because I inherited sin. Like, that's my fault or something, you know? But it's not even about that. It's about realizing that God made man and woman, made a creation, and it rebelled against Him. So now he's got to the point where, you know, he got to the point where he's just fed up with everyone, you know. That's why, like, the flood, he wiped everyone out. Like, oh, I'll just wipe them all out, start over, kind of thing. He has the right to do that too. He's not wrong for doing that. he sees evil and he wants to get rid of it, he has all the rights to do that. So, and it says, like, oh, and then he gave the covenant of the rainbow, saying, I will never do that by water again. He was very specific that he will never destroy the whole world by flood and water again. But that doesn't mean that he won't smite the whole world again and get rid of evil again. It's just by water. It was very specific to water. So that's something that some people should, you want to tread carefully around that one, because God can wipe people out whenever he wants to. He can just take his spirit back from them and take his life back from them if they're not serving and appreciative. But anyway, so like, I just wanted to touch on that scripture because a lot of people get confused about it. It tells me to love all others, and then why is it telling me to hate everyone, even my parents and this and that? Yeah, because to initially turn to God and Jesus, you have to get fed up to the point where you hate everyone and everything. And then you turn to God, you cry out to him, you ask him to save you, you repent for your sins, even your own evil ways. You get sick of your own life. You get sick of yourself, everyone in it. You just get tired of everything. So once you get there, then you call out to God and you ask God, and then he makes you his disciple. That's why it says anyone that comes to him that doesn't do that is not worthy, because you have to be at that point to become a disciple of Jesus, because you are just fed up with the world. So you have to turn away from the world, even your worldly self and sins and all that. So then once you do that and you repent, then you walk away, then God teaches you how to love all others as yourself. But first, you have to get to the point where you hate everyone first. But you don't continue, once you come to know God, you don't continue in hating everyone, because then God gives you more and more understanding that these people don't know any better. They don't understand either yet. So you have to have compassion and mercy and love and understanding yourself, and then to forgive all that, because you were a sinner too. So, you know, that's why it says, like, he who is without sin may cast the first stone. We're not without sin. So no, that's saying, like, no one has the right to cast stones at anyone, because we're all sinners. So I just wanted to clarify that, because it can be a confusing scripture, you know. Like, I was confused about that scripture when I first came to it. I was like, I gotta hate everyone. You gotta hate your own mother and father. Like, that doesn't make any sense. It's contradictory, and there's lots of things that are like that. That's why it says the wisdom is hidden in the scriptures, because to non-believers it seems like foolishness, because you don't have that perspective. You haven't opened your heart and your mind open to God yet, so he hasn't revealed things to you yet, because you have not asked to be his vessel yet. You have not asked for revelation yet. So once you do, and you get to that point, like I was saying, you get so fed up, broken down, you hate everyone and everything. You're even yourself, you're just tired of the world. Like I said, like in my track, Sick of People, you can see in that song I'm clearly sick of people, you know. Like, I'm just there, you know. Like, I was just like, I'm done with this, I'm sick of myself, I'm sick of everything. That's when you hate everything, everyone, even yourself. Then you cry out to God. God will save you. You call out to God, those promises are true. He will save you. If you're truly repentant and you need help and you don't want to live that life anymore, you turn to God through Jesus Christ, he will save you and he'll help you. And then he teaches you. That's what heals you, is you learn the compassion. You become more and more Christ-like as you get to know him more and more. You want to be more and more like him, and you relate to him because you feel betrayed. You feel like, you know, like all these people are crucifying you, persecuting you. So he's who you relate to. He's our example. He's our perfect example. So that's who we're supposed to be aspiring to be like. But yeah, it takes getting fed up. It takes hating everyone at first. But then that goes away. You don't hate them anymore. Then eventually he replaces that hate with compassion, mercy, salvation, love, understanding. And then you begin to love and view all others as yourself. Because to love all others as yourself, you have to actually understand that they are yourself. So you have to view them as yourself, because they're existing in your heart right now, in your mind, within you. They're characters in you right now. So they're one with you. They're a part of you. You hate them or hurt them or are against them, that's like hating, hurting, or being against God. Like a part of God and yourself. So until you come to that revelation where you love all others as yourself and view all others as a part of yourself, you won't understand. Anyway, much love. Live to love, love to live. Peace.